So today it is damp. There's no snow on the ground, but it's probably close to freezing, and it's just so damp. You just walk out and you feel cold. It's just this dampness that just seeps into everything. And I'm sure it's seeping into the bees right now. And it's kind of remarkable that these bees can stay alive in these little wooden boxes that we force them to live in this weather and in this climate, because it just seems like it's gotta be damp and cold in there. It can't feel comfortable for these bees inside these hives. But we do it. Anyway, I put on the quarter inch mesh on the bottom of most of my hives today. I should have had this on much earlier. But hopefully I got it on soon enough before any mice have gone into the hive looking for a nice warm place to live. I might check with my thermal camera at a later date to see if there's any sign of mice inside, but I really should have had this on earlier. And most of my hives still don't have the quarter inch mesh on, but anyway, it'll do for now. What else was I gonna say? Oh yeah, this bottom board. It's damp, like it's wet. We had a lot of heavy rain today, and this part of the bottom board is just soaked. Even though the hive is tilted so that any water in the hive will theoretically pour out the front of the hive, the bottom here, that dampness still gets, I mean, that wood still gets pretty damp, right? And it just soaks up the moisture, and that moisture gets into the hive. Most of my bottom boards, when I started, came from Bee Made in Manitoba, and all the components that I got from Bee Made, the bottom boards, the inner covers, and the top covers, were all wax dipped, and the wax dip components have, I guess, water resistance built into them because of that wax. They just don't get damp like this. But over the years, the wax has worn off and melted or whatever, and now they're getting pretty damp. So I'm going to look into next year putting a coating of wax on them, at least on my bottom boards, at least one side of my bottom boards, so that they don't absorb so much moisture from outside. I've put on this year, I've put this silver bubble wrap on all of my hives over the inner covers, and the inner covers have a hole there, and you can see the bees there. In a hive like this is a really strong colony over here in this hive, and you can see there are no bees clustering up top, and I got a this one up there is like that too, and it's great. I don't want them clustering up top. I want them down below. But the smaller ones, like this is only a 2-medium hive, so they probably got nowhere else to cluster. And the other thing I'm doing today is I'm dumping in some of these hive pillows, these burlap pillows full of wood chips. And I had a friend of mine sew up a few of them last year. And these are two that happen to be a little bit, they didn't work out as well as the other ones. This one is square, but it's got a fair amount of wood chips in it. And this one is not square, but it's a bit light, not a lot of wood chips in it. But it's still good enough, right? And basically, I'm going to take it, and I'm dumping it. I'm putting it inside the top of the hive here. And that's it. Now this should have, this is an empty medium super, but it should be a ventilation rim. It should have holes in the side. So that's sort of what I'm doing. It's sort of a moisture quilt. It's a mishmash of whatever, other things. And I'm just gonna see if it works. You can see this other hive. Here's a hive that's looking great. And I don't think it needs anything. But you can see here, these bees are barely clustering up top. And same deal, but they've got this is a pure, complete ventilation rim. And I think this hive alone, just like this, could work and do fine throughout the winter. It's a strong colony. They've got a ton of honey. And all that honey is acting as insulation. They've got an inner cover with an inner cover hole. This little bit of insulation here, but again, I don't know if we need it. And any moisture or condensation that's inside that hive gets carried by the heat outside of that hole, and then just sort of evaporates outside those ventilation rims, you know, the holes in the ventilation rim. Or to be a little extra careful, I guess I could dump in a pile of wood chips. And those wood chips perhaps will provide a little bit of extra insulation, but also absorb any moisture that gets in and out of the hive. A moisture quilt would work the same way. Basically, a moisture quilt would have the whole bottom would be open. It wouldn't have just that hole. It would be, the inner cover would practically be gone. And you'd have a moisture quilt on top full of moisture, full of wood chips. And all that moisture would rise up. It would rise through as vapor. It would go through the wooden chips. And then it would hit the top of the inner, the cold top of the inner cover where it condenses. And once it condenses up on that cold surface, it drips down on this, these wood chips. And there, from there, laying on the surface of the wood chips, it evaporates out the holes of the inner cover. And that's basically the how most things with wood chips work, if you have upper ventilation and a cold surface for the condensation to hit, right? So theoretically, that's what's going on here. You know, the hot air with moisture will rise up through that hole, go through the inner, through the pillow, hit that thing, and then evaporate out. I don't know if you actually need this pillow or these wood chips. I think, because like last year, I had a hive set up with no wrap and no insulation, and it was just a ventilation rim over an inner cover just like this, and that was it. The bees were dry all winter long, and they did great. In fact, they did incredibly great, and that's why I'm experimenting with doing the opposite of what a lot of people tell me I should do. Because I know we go through a great deal of effort to keep our bees warm and cozy all winter long, but I did nothing with this hive last winter, and they just, it was probably the best colony I've ever seen. So it's, I'm just experimenting to see with my own eyes what works and what doesn't, and how much effort do I really need to put into this. My ideal situation would be do nothing. I'll give them a ventilation rim, and that's it. I'd be happy with just doing that. And I kind of think that you can get away with that in certain locations. Maybe not here in Flat Rock, where it's really cold and really damp, and my hives don't get a lot of direct sunlight. But in other conditions, I think you could pull it off. But anyway, that's what I'm doing today. Or that's what I've done. The inside of this cover is damp, so I gotta replace it. So that's all my beekeeping for today. Just put a little bit of mesh down there and put some of those pillows over the inner covers that have... See, these bees are clustering up top. But anyway, we'll see. And I'm going to put probably a little bit of that silver wrap on some of these hives just to see what happens. Probably the smaller ones that have two mediums. This one's got two mediums, that one's got two mediums, and that one has two mediums. So we'll see.